Victoria University has become the 11th private university to get a charter. The charter was officially handed over to them this evening by the National Council for Higher Education at their headquarters in Intinda. Mary Okwakol, the executive director of the National Council for Higher Education, commended Victoria University for having demonstrated high quality in teaching, staffing, ICT and infrastructure development, some of the key requirements for any university to be granted a charter.
One is observance of principles of good governance. Two is continuous improvement of the infrastructure and facilities of your institution, because now and again we expect you'll be presenting programs for accreditation. But in order for those programs to be accredited, among the key requirements that you must have the appropriate infrastructure and facilities. Three, ensuring that you implement academic programs accredited by the National Council for Education. I've already said that, but for emphasis. Four, hiring qualified permanent academic and administrative staff.
She warned that poor teaching standards will see the universities losing their charters.
Violation of the charter conditions can lead to it being revoked. And surely wouldn't like to do that. In fact, I would like to, at this juncture, to inform you that we would like every university, every institution under our supervision to excel. And when we revoke a license, it's painful for us. We don't just wish to do it, but because we are given a duty, if it is necessary to do it.
I've taken a lot of guidance from National Council for Higher Education, and we have an amazing Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, we have an amazing Council and the Senate. Mr. Billy Burma is one of the Council members, the Vice-Chairperson of the Council. So it was a very robust exercise. It's not so easy. It took us 3 years. To achieve this.
Report by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.